So we should be live now.
Yeah, and then
So I heard the.
I would switch over to the intro. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's been about 10 seconds here, so just make sure it shouldn't up here. Maybe I should switch. Cool. Yeah, so we're all good. You can go ahead and go to camera. Hey everybody, welcome to the broadcast this morning. We couldn't be more excited to be here because we're celebrating the latest game update for The Sims 4, which has added pools to the game, which is fantastic. Woo! So everybody who owns The Sims 4 is going to get the pools in a free update. If you haven't yet launched your game this morning, don't do it right now because we want you to hang out here with us for the next little bit. But as soon as you go into Origin, it's going to automatically add pools into your game and you can just go in and start playing with them.
Yep.
So we're very excited about that. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Graham. I'm one of the producers on the game. And I am joined by Stephanie this morning.
Hi, guys.
another one of our producers. Maybe you could just introduce yourself. I know you haven't done one of these big streams before.
So for a Sims 4 base game, I mainly worked on Built Mode, and this is kind of my intro into a little bit of everything.
Yeah. And you were actually the producer who worked directly on pools, right?
Yep.
Cool. So lots of good stuff to see today.
Yeah, we got a lot to show today.
Why don't we go ahead and just jump in the game?
Yep. Let's get started.
So, you know, similar to the way that you always start in, out in The Sims, I figured we would start in Create a Sim this morning. Because, of course, if we're going to have pools, we need to have some new swimwear as well. So, yeah, if you just take a look at your outfits, we've added a new one on the top right there, the little tube dude. And so you can start adding swimwear to your Sim. So we got a nice long trunks there, the Speedo look, you know, the cougar leopard pattern. So some fun options. But you know, it's the male's kind of pedestrian. We got some more options for the women, right? They can get a little more fashionable with it all. So we've got tops and bottoms if we want to go that route. Of course, a lot of different varieties in terms of color and all that.
Got tops, bottoms. We also have full bodies for the females, so if you want to mix and match, you can, but you also have your full body basics and...
Yeah, and the nice thing with these ones, they have the patterns or kind of the plain version as well, depending on what you want. Also, yeah, swimwear for kids. Of course, kids can go swimming just as much as the adults can, so some new options for them as well.
Got a cute tankini.
Little polka dots.
Switching over to the boys. Here's some more styled looks.
Oh yeah, of course, we've got the styled looks for swimwear as well now. So if you actually go in there, you'll find a few different ones. We can try that one on. He seems pretty impressed
by it.
That's
pretty cute.
And there's actually a couple of new accessories in this update as well, right? So we'll just jump up to his face here because we've got some, oh yeah, the shark tooth necklace. I like that one. Or we've got some new kind of makeup, but in the form of sunblock.
Some sunscreen. Maybe put one on the boy, too.
And I saw somebody asking this earlier, actually, and I just wanted to show it up front while we're still here in Create a Sim. They were curious, you know, of course you can go into the pool with your swimwear on. What if you wanted to wear something totally zany, like the hot dog suit? Could you do that?
Yes, you can. But I mean, we didn't kind of leave any restrictions for players. You can select whatever.
Right, so like when you're coming in here, it says no results found, and we're on swimwear. But if you just click that filter up there and take that off, now you can select from any outfit in the game. So if I wanted to go swimming in my hot dog suit, totally could. But let's get him back into some normal swimwear. I just wanted to show people the possibilities. Oh yeah, people are liking the sunscreen. Where are we going? Are we going Speedos?
Let's do it.
All right. So let's hop into game now. And I think we'll do build mode first. Just show off some of the different ways that you can add pools to the game. There's actually some brand new things here in The Sims 4 and a lot of ways to kind of customize and add pools that you might not be aware of when you first jump in.
Okay.
Wow, the Twitch broadcast is really going. There's a lot of comments streaming in. I'm going to try and grab people's fun comments as we go. And if I happen to see questions pop up as well, we'll try and answer some of those. And we'll get to a whole Q&A thing at the end of the broadcast as well. So as soon as you hop into build mode, you just click that pool on the house, right? And you've got a bunch of different options here. Maybe show us some of the different ones.
So we have pool tool, triangle, basic triangle, squares, diagonal.
Yeah, and that's really cool, actually. I want to call that one out because I know a lot of our fans ask for diagonal pools over and over again during Sims 3, and we never got them. But yeah, true to Sims 2 form, right? We've got diagonal pools back in there, and it's so much fun for being able to adjust your pools in cool ways. Yeah.
And the way pools work is very similar to the way we build rooms, so they merge together if you put them next to each other, and you can push and pull like you do with rooms. So we try to keep it very consistent with rooms, so it's not...
Yeah.
Too much of a change.
Basically, if you're already familiar with kind of building a home in The Sims 4, the pools are going to feel just like a natural extension of that. Now, when I first started editing pools and trying to build my own in Sims 4, something that I just didn't quite catch initially was how to delete individual pieces. Because if you were to take a sledgehammer to this, it's going to delete the entire pool, right?
Yeah.
So maybe just show people how they can start to edit pieces of their pool once they've placed it down.
So if you hold control with the pool tool, it'll build parts of parts of the pool back in. If you want to do it that way and kind of create the shape that you want. Try to make my pool a little bit bigger.
Right. So basically just grab onto that pool tool, the first one in there, hold down the control key, and then drag out whatever space you want to delete. So you can delete a one by one space.
Or you can create an island.
Yeah, make a cool pool island like that. So that's kind of a fun, advanced way to build with pools, to make something really unique looking or just to edit what you've already placed. Now, something else that you look like you're almost making some sort of word there. It's coming together. I saw some really fun like lots on the gallery recently where people were building homes in like the shapes of words, and I don't know, it was neat, but...
I think Aaron built a mustache of you guys following him on Twitter.
Was that for Movember?
Yeah, it was.
I always wanted to say Movember for some... Coolvember. There we go. Why don't you show us another cool option? One that I really liked was the ability to build not just on the terrain, but on those floor tiles over there, because we'll see something really interesting in a moment.
Let's do octagonal.
So this was something you could do in past Sims games, of course, just add them on the floor tiles, same as the terrain. But something you couldn't do in The Sims 3 was have a pool on a deck or a foundation.
Yep.
So there we go. We just raised it right up. The pool's there along with us. You can build your pools wherever you want now. So add them on a deck or foundation. And I think that's, you know, just a natural thing for how people kind of build their homes in real life. So that'll be pretty nice.
Get it. Let's just do this.
There you go. So that's looking pretty good. Maybe let's show some of the options. Once you have a pool, what can you do inside of it? Maybe even make that one a little bit bigger so we can drop some more objects in there. There we go, so we'll drag it out. And if we go back into the pool section now, that ladder there is where you're going to find all your pool objects. So place a ladder anywhere. Something I thought was kind of neat in The Sims 4 is you can finally place a ladder on a diagonal edge of a pool now.
All right, let's try that.
There you go. I went back and I was playing Sims 2 recently and I tried and I was like, can't do that. But so now we've got it here. We've got a variety of pool lights that came in the update, so we can have kind of a classier one there and one that looks like it might be a little more industrial.
Yeah, maybe for like a community pool or something.
Yeah, and of course if you hold down the Alt key, you can do free placement of all of your lights anywhere you want and just kind of put a bunch of them if you really wanted to. And the nice thing about these lights is they're not just pool lights either. If you just wanted to place them on a normal wall, you totally can, right? Why don't we actually hop to live mode for just a moment?
Okay.
Because people keep asking if you can change the color of your lights once they're in the pool. Maybe just show a little bit of how you do that.
You just click on them like you do any regular lights, and you set the intensity or the color. So you can pick this light or all lights, but you pick blue, purple. We probably won't be able to see that in the nighttime, but we'll set it up for later.
Sure, sure. We can see that. Yeah, we'll see it when it gets dark tonight. Let's see. We've got a few questions coming in over here about live mode. We're going to get to that in just a moment. But let's actually show a couple more of those build objects first. And somebody was actually interested. Tiger Lily Zero asked, how do you change depth of the pools?
So what you do is you select the pool, and like you do with the rooms, you click on the little context menu, and they have the different depths.
So medium and the one that I like to call scary deep.
That's scary deep.
So not only does that work for pools on decks and foundations, you can change the depth on the terrain. You could also change the depth if you were to edit a pool above ground.
Yep.
And maybe we'll show that in a second once we finish off with some of the objects.
Okay.
So let's get a couple of the other nice decorative ones in there. Yeah, so we've got some mosaics we can drop down.
This is big enough for the big one.
Oh, not quite. So we've got mosaics of two sizes, which is nice. So you can play with some different shapes. So, yeah, Stephanie showed me this really classy looking one where she overlaps them.
I do a lot of stacking.
And then we got the turtle family. So the big mama turtle. We've got some little kid turtles too.
And like all of our objects, they come in different variants too. So you get different colors.
And I really like the floor light that we can do now as well. So those are pretty nice. Lights it up beautifully at nighttime.
And the lights that we provide for pools, you can also place them in your home too if you want to place them.
Let's see. So Skeezer MC was asking if there's a pool wall option. I'm guessing he's asking about some of the materials, the new ones that we added in the update.
Yes, we do. Let me pop over there real quick.
So yeah, of course, with pools added to the game now, we wanted to add some kind of appropriate materials that you could build them with.
Yeah.
So there's a variety of new wall options, and you could use them in the pool, or I don't know, some of them are tile. They look nice in the kitchen
and
bathroom,
too. Yeah, and they have coordinating floor patterns, too, so you'll be able to kind of coordinate. This is one of them in black. Let me do one in blue so you can see. This is the one we have default. If you place the pool, it has a tiling on top.
Yep.
And then we have one that kind of just has a little bit more your traditional pool with the waves.
Nice. And we've got some of those floor tiles as well, right?
Yes. Switch over. So here's the kind of the specs one.
Oh, I like that.
That one looks nice. And then, let's see, the matching water one, I think.
Oh, you know, something cool for build mode. I know a lot of people don't know about this. If you just press the G key, you can actually turn the grid off. I love doing this when I'm building like my wall materials and floor materials, because I feel like it just lets me get a better view of what it's going to look like when it's final. So yeah, that's
cool
pretty.
Step.
But we can turn it back on. I know. We're going
like
to do a little
grid.
More building in a second here. So Euromaster was asking, can we have different depths in the same pool? And right now that's a no, right? Can't do that?
Correct.
Yeah. So it's kind of similar to the way that you adjust walls on different levels, where it's per level is what the depth of the walls or the pool will be. So that's kind of how it changes.
Yeah.
Yep. Now, Dr. Ged was interested if you can place pools in the houses with windows around the pool. So maybe let's show some of those pools on the upper floors.
Sure.
So another really cool component that we're adding with the pools, they don't just have to be on the ground floor. You can actually add pools on the first floor or the upper floor or the roof, you know, wherever you want. Go build a pool.
Here's one of the ones we have interior where you can place a window just like you do with regular windows, and you can delete them. But,
and it can be any window you want. Like,
yep.
I like using kind of those full bodied ones because they give you a really cool view in there.
Yeah.
But you can get creative with it, place different windows down.
I think for a lot of the indoor pools that I build, I use a lot of the contemporary ones so you can actually see a lot of what's going on.
Yeah. You've got a really pretty one on the top floor that I like on this house. Oh, you haven't actually added
it yet. I haven't built it yet. I'll show you guys.
Let's So there we go. And it actually preserved the windows on the exterior of the home. So it's smart when you're building it like that. And just to try and make it easy for people. But that looks like a great pool to throw a party in if we wanted to. So that's
nice
fun.
Nice rooftop pool. I don't know if you guys saw either. I placed a couple of one of our new pool gnomes.
Oh yeah, this is fun, right? So you know, in each of the patches or updates that have come out so far, there's been a new gnome. No exception this time. So we've got our cute little pool gnome there.
She's female.
What's her name? Does she have a name in the catalog?
Pool gnome. All right. Side gnome.
We're sticking a different writer on that one next time. Oh boy. Hey, and it looks like we actually have some special builders from our community joining us today in the live stream. Just a quick hello and shout out to Cinderella Mouse and Ruthless KK and Howdy Simmer. So,
hi guys.
Yeah, cool. They have awesome stuff up on the gallery, mm-hmm. I'm sure. So you should check out some of their lots as well. That's actually a good thing to mention, just with the gallery and the update going live today. Yep. We're going to put the lot that you see from this broadcast up on the gallery.
We'll probably do that later today and hopefully look around and curate some of your guys' stuff that you guys are building as well.
Yeah, so rush out there as soon as this broadcast is over, make something really awesome looking with pools, and then tweet at The Sims and beg for it to be, you know, curated onto the gallery, and maybe you'll get thousands of downloads. We'll see.
Yeah. Exciting.
Let's see. I'm just going to scroll through this. I've been skipping some of the live mode comments because we're about to get to it. I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything build related here. Oh, so one kind of question about the objects. This could fall in either one. But they were interested about diving boards or pool slides. Mm-hmm. And that wasn't something that we focus on for this update. I mean, there's always the possibility in the future.
Yeah.
So no pool slides or diving boards right now. We really kind of wanted to build on the strength of what we did with the base game, with a lot of socializing and group dynamics. And we're going to see that in the pools.
We're going
to show
some of that today.
So, yeah, I'm not missing anything build-related here.
There's one thing that I wanted to show, kind of the workaround of doing just the foundation.
Oh, yeah. This is super clever. This is like an advanced builder trick. I'm glad you remembered this. Because, you know, of course you can make pools that are functional, but what about a pool that's beautiful and is used purely as a decorative for the lot? There's a really cool trick here that we can do, and it involves changing the foundation height. So any pool on the ground floor that's attached to a wall, if you start at foundation level zero, the base, you know, no foundation, and then you raise it up, any pool attached to that wall is going to be raised up as well. But you can then delete the wall, and you actually have this raised pool. And if you want, you could add stairs, and Sims could use it. But if you didn't add those stairs, then it's just purely decorative.
It can be decorative, yeah.
One thing I really like for the pools, actually, especially for the decorative ones, those lily pads that you can add.
Oh, yeah. So if you look under fountains, we had a couple kind of decorative things you can add. And you can totally add pads on there.
So speaking of lily pads, actually, let's see, Lunak, maybe that's close, was interested if we can add fish to our swimming pools. Now there's kind of a tricky way to do that.
Right? But...
So it's not officially supported.
Yeah.
In our last game update that went out, we actually added a cheat that let you access some of those kind of fishing objects, things that set up fishing. So if you add the cheat bb.showhiddenobjects, all one word, and then you go into build mode, there's going to be a special debug filter, and you can find some fishing objects in there. If you place one of those along the edge of a pool, you could actually go fishing
in
the
pool,
right?
It's actually the sign.
Yeah,
yeah. The sign, if you put it near a pool, you'd probably be able to fish.
So that's a little trick, not officially supported, but I'm sure people will find some really creative things to do with that. One other object question quickly.
Okay.
Mary Kate and Fan want to know if ladders are mandatory.
Ladders are not mandatory, and we'll show you guys that in a bit.
Okay. So let's go ahead and hop over to live mode. We've seen lots of cool ways to build pools, but how are our Sims going to enjoy the pools? So we'll bring them all out here and start enjoying things. And we've actually added some new things in terms of gameplay to what you can do in pools and sims now. I think it's really awesome the way that you can sit on the edge of the pools, and we'll see that in a second. But even just the group dynamics in a pool are really cool. So when we get everybody out here, we can start socializing and just having fun in a pool with multiple sims in ways that you just couldn't do previously.
They're going to talk to each other instead.
Oh, do we still have autonomy on for them? We're going to shut autonomy off for a moment. We want them to do exactly what we're telling them to do.
Just do on direct.
Okay, we can do that. All right, everybody back in the pool. Ooh, and he's angry at the moment. Let's actually take advantage of that while he's angry.
All right.
Because we have some emotional ways to go swimming as well. It sounds a little funny to say. But what that really means is that you can see in their faces and the way they're swimming, part of the way that they're feeling. So it isn't just a renamed interaction. That's actually going to have an impact on the way they look while they're in the pool. And there's a couple different examples of that, right? So angry's one of them.
Sad's another one. Energized and playful. Hopefully we'll run into those kind of emotions and show you guys those.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let me have them socialize.
Yeah, let's get like a group chat going in the pool. Oh no, she's going to the bathroom. That's going to ruin one of our later moments. We need somebody with a low bladder in just a little bit, but we'll get it set up right. Where'd the mom go?
I don't know.
She run off somewhere?
Oh, she went to swim in the other pool.
Nope, everybody in this pool.
Let's do one pool at a time.
So is he actually swimming laps at the moment? Is that what he's up to?
Yes, he's swimming the angry lap.
Oh, okay,
so he also gets
I think we got to do full autonomy off if we're going to get a group chat going here. All right, all of you in the pool. Do as I say. That's part of the fun of The Sims.
Oh, she's sleeping.
Oh, she tired?
It's okay, we'll wake her up.
Get up. she might be my candidate for energy motive failing in the pool.
We can do that.
If she's already a little tired. So when we talk about socializing in the pool, you know, it's not just a special interaction. You actually have all the socialization options available. So you see that menu is going to pop up and they can start having conversations and you can talk about anything you want. And just like, you know, any conversation outside of the pool, you're still going to get the cool skill gains that go along with those socials. And, you know, it's all very natural.
Oh, he's swimming playful.
Oh, there we go. So playful was another one of those emotional swimming styles. So if we zoom in closely on him, we'll get a look at that.
He's swimming too fast.
He's a good little swimmer.
Look at, he's happy. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me try to get his face.
And actually, you might notice the skill bar above his head as well. So we don't have a swimming skill, but sims do gain skills by swimming. For the children, they gain the motor skill, and adults gain the athletic skill, right? Or fitness. There we go.
All right, getting them in a combo.
So now that they're all in a group conversation as well, you can have some of them sit on the edge of the pool, right? And they can continue socializing with sims who are still in the pool, which is pretty neat. So all these dynamics kind of come into play to set up really natural scenes. So Tinu wants to know, how did you drag up their knees? So we're actually playing on a developer build at the moment. It gives us access to a few more kind of cheat debug commands.
Yeah.
So right now that's not something that you can do as a player in game, is drag their cheat bars or their knee bars around. I've seen people asking for that, so maybe we could add that in an update someday. I don't know, but let us know if that's something you guys want. Be something to think about. Yeah, so do I. So let's get two of them on the edge of the pool and show how they can start conversing with each other and maybe the ways that they can chat, you know, from edge to in pool as well, which is neat. Oh, Steve Owley 96 is interested if pregnant Sims can swim in pools. We don't have one right now to show, but they can, right?
That's, yeah, we don't have any restrictions for pregnant Sims.
Imagining Mystic is interested if pools will affect builds a lot. So pools don't have a specific effect on builds, but it ties into the value of your household lot. You know, depending on kind of the value of your lot, and you can see that up in the lot info panel in build mode, that'll impact how much your builds are. So you will certainly see a raise cost of your builds when you add a pool, but it's not something specific to pools themselves. Oh no, they're doing a little splashing, right?
Yeah.
Which is fun. So splash is one of the interactions that you can do in the pool, but it doesn't have to be just the Sims in the pool. They can actually splash Sims who are sitting on the edge as well, which is pretty nice. And you can already see how they're conversing and socializing back and forth here, but they don't even need to be sitting, right? You could just have a Sim walk up to the edge of the pool and start chatting with the Sim who's in the pool, right?
Yeah, they can be standing up and chatting with someone from the pool.
Yeah, so it's really kind of sets up a natural scene for however you want to play your game. It makes great settings just by the poolside. Ooh, Hannah wants to know if ghosts can swim. We can answer that one right now, but we're actually going to show you something a little spooky in a bit here. Ghosts can swim, though, right? Nothing's stopping them. I'm going to scroll back up and chat a little bit because I skipped over some Lig Mode questions earlier, and I want to make sure I get to them. Diddle783 was interested, if a Sim is pregnant, will the belly be shown when she's wearing a bikini? Yeah, sure will. And Alice Tatiana was interested if there are pool community lots. So there isn't a specific pool lot type. You might have remembered the community pool from Sims 3, but there's nothing stopping you from building a pool on any
community.
Putting
in a park or anything like that.
Yeah, so you can totally do that if you want to. Simmer Fangirl is interested, how many Sims can you have in the pool at the same time? There's no limit, right?
As many as you can get in.
So you can get up to 20 Sims, I believe, on a lot at any given time. So if you want to get all 20 of them jumping in the pool, go for it. Barbahoy, Shusha. Let's see here.
I'm going to show you guys a quick kind of fun interaction.
Oh, here we go. All right, we're moving on to the deviant part of the broadcast. So, if your bladder's a little bit low, you can pee in the pool. Do you actually?
I did already. I can do it again.
So take a close look around him. You'll see this little cloud appear around him. Just so you know if anybody's behaving inappropriately. Let's see. Oh yeah, there he is. And take a look at his moodlet there. He's got a new one, right? Just to the right. His little pants on. Secretly relieved. So he enjoyed himself. One of the benefits of being a child, I guess you just don't have to care.
Yeah, and the Sim next to him kind of got uncomfortably warm.
Ooh, gross.
This is something silly.
Oh, here's an actually a couple of interesting build ones that we didn't touch on beforehand.
Okay.
Frega was interested if you can build fountains in the pools. Is that possible?
In the pools?
Yeah, so you know how we have the fountain tool and we have those like fountains that shoot up water on them. Can you place those ones in the pool?
I don't think you can if we prevent those, because those actually kind of have a little nubbin on the bottom to kind of like make it look like it's coming from the bottom.
Oh, right.
So if for pools, it just wouldn't look good.
Yeah, it would look like it's coming from the bottom of the pool. And another interesting build one, and this actually touches on something I wanted to mention. Rookie, can you build a wall over the pool and then swim under the wall to like swim from the outside to inside or something? Pretty sure you can't do that, right?
Yeah.
But what we do have now is the ability to build walls and fences right up to the edge of the pool. That was something you couldn't do in The Sims 3. It made it a little tricky to drown your Sims if you really wanted to. But yeah, now you can build fences and walls right along the edge. And it looks like you've made a clever little pool here.
Setting us up.
What could you possibly be doing, Stephanie? So who's the lucky sim today who's going to try out our nice new pool?
Let's do Luca today.
Howdy Simmer has a question here. Can you swim in the rivers in Willow Creek or not? That's not something that was added in this update. So this one's all about swimming in the pools. Who'd you throw in there? I didn't even
Luca,
see.
Okay. The dad.
Oh, that's one of those fences that's hard to click on. There we go.
We're going to trap him in a little bit. Don't try this out.
It's all right. I've coined the term murder pool. I don't know. Maybe that's over the top for the Sims. That's what I like to call it. But he is in trouble suddenly. So you can see he is not feeling good. He just got the notification. Swimming while hungry may cause a Sim to drown. Thank you for telling me, The Sims. good to know. Carry on. So a few more interesting questions coming in. Jay Liu, while we're on the subject of death here, can the elderly suffer from overexertion in the pool? So you know how when they're exercising a lot, they can suddenly...
So you do get fatigue.
Yep. So that can happen to your elders. You got to watch out.
Swimming is just like any other exercise you can do.
Mm-hmm. Latrix would like to know if your Sims will need to clean the pools.
No cleaning.
I think we saw when he peed in the pool that little puff of stuff around him. I want to think that was the chlorine just absorbing, you know, any nastiness. But hopefully we've got our pools balanced right and they're staying clean on their own. Devia Simmer would like to know if there is any pool woohoo.
No pool woohoo.
Yeah, no
just
woohoo in the pools
this
in this update. Now, this is an interesting one. Luis Barros would like to know if they can eat in the pool. Now, they can't hop in the pool and eat, but you can actually sit on the edge of the pool with drinks and food, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's kind of one of the forms of multitasking. Oh no!
We missed it, so I may have to kill someone else.
Wait, did we even zoom in and look at it when it happened?
I missed it.
Okay, no. Let the killing spree continue. Open the pool back up. We're getting another victim in.
It has to be a kid.
That's fine. So that's no, it's fine. Put one of the kids in there. So people asked us beforehand because it used to be we added ghosts to the game last time and we have fire. And previously, fire was the only way that kids could die in The Sims 4. So, here you go. Now with pools, one more way for your kids to kick the bucket. So, we're going to have her hop in there, right? Yep. Sorry. Jump in. The water's nice.
The next victim.
Destiny, on the subject of death, wanted to know, if you take the ladder out of the pool, do they drown? And that's a no.
No, because they can jump in the pools from the edge.
They're smart enough to be able to climb back out.
Yep.
So really, you want to wall them off like this or kind of keep them focused in the pool if you're turning. You know, if they get low on energy or hunger, you can force them to kind of stay in there if you really want them to drown.
So Kale right now is sad because his dad just died. So we can show you guys this dad's swim.
Oh, perfect. Look at that. I love when things work out nicely. Oh, he just switched back to happy, didn't he? Oh, there we go.
Oh, there
sad.
You go.
Okay. So here's the sad swim. He's kind of moping around. Baby Fishley wanted to know, can we do a pool party? So you might have remembered pool parties in The Sims 3. We didn't add a specific pool party, but you can throw a party and just have everybody hop in the pool.
Yeah.
You know, that's essentially what we thought we'd do with it.
Yeah.
You can have a party centered around pools if you want, but it's not a specific option in the pool menu. So we don't want to miss it this time. Let's zoom in close and see what happens here.
There's some socialization while she's trapped.
Oh, wait, let's drop her energy, right? Because hunger takes even longer. So if we drop her energy down, that'll...
Oh.
Wow, she is in all sorts of trouble there. So Simmer Pop Black said, my Sims got into the pool with their regular clothing. And yeah, like we showed earlier in the broadcast, that's something you can totally do. If you set up your swimwear and just take off that swimming filter, yeah, you can wear whatever you want inside the pool. Yeah, have fun with it, be a little weird with it. All right, so let's take a look at her moodlet down there, because it'll show us exactly how long until the flash. Oh, there we go.
Oh,
oh
no!
Oh, it's too small. We got to make a larger pool. So she wasn't. If there's not enough room in the pool, we're gonna have to kill off another one. If there's not enough room, essentially because they play this really gruesome animation, they're just gonna kick the bucket immediately when they die. So let's make another large one and throw another sim in there. This is turning into a kind of grim broadcast.
I don't think I've ever killed this many in one sim. I'm not a killer. Alright.
I gotta browse the comments for a second. People are gonna laugh at this. Simison says, kill them all. Destiny said, stop killing people. Destiny, you asked about a death-related question. Don't tell me to stop killing people now. You started this.
Alright, hopefully that's big enough.
Bernie Sim is interested if skinny dipping is an option.
Skinny dipping is not an option for this update.
Okay.
Okay.
Think that's a large enough one? Are we good to go?
I hope so.
Alright. We'll try it out. We'll
then
throw
I'll
another
have to
one
kill the whole family.
We're not ending this broadcast until I see a Sim drowning. So let's see. Audie Loves Dogs want to know if you can make stairs go into the pool. So we saw a little earlier in the broadcast, if you build one of those higher kind of above ground type pools, you can have stairs lead up to it, but you can't have stairs that go down into the pool, right?
Correct.
Yeah. Devious Simmer wanted to know if the hydrophobic trait is back. I don't think we added any new traits with this update, right?
You do get, kind of touching in on ghosts a little bit. If you're a ghost, you get kind of the boss.
Oh, wall him off quickly. He's trying to get out.
Okay. Sorry. I wall him off right now.
There we go.
All right, he's in. Oh, he popped out. How? I don't know.
Oh, he was probably already trying to get out, so just threw him out of the pool. Sims are being tricky today.
I keep deleting that pool.
Zookie Sue was interested if there's any move objects cheat with the pool update. That's not part of this update. Something we've heard a lot of feedback on. It's something we're interested in. Keep letting us know if that's something you want, but not in this update. So they're starting to ask about what kind of powers ghosts have, and I swear we're going to successfully get one here.
We'll get there
eventually. So let's drop his energy down. Let's speed three and get watch when he's about to die here. All right, three hours. All right, we'll take some more questions while he's getting a little more tired here. Kara wanted to know if there's any pool accessories or more interactions, such as slide, inflatables, water polo. I mentioned a little bit earlier, what we really wanted to do with pools in this update was take advantage of kind of the things that are new about The Sims 4. So kind of those great group dynamics, the ways that they can socialize with each other, and adding really interesting things where you're not just in the pool, but you can still socialize and chat with people outside of the pool, on the edge of the pool. So you can splash while you're in the pool, but that's what we've added in this update. Okay, are we there?
Try not to miss it.
Let's zoom in really close. What time is it? Yeah, 20 minutes. Okay. All right, we got this.
Look at his face. I'm sorry.
Steph, you are a cruel taskmaster. Oh, And Nope Wimbley says, stop killing them. They all have feelings. They don't have feelings. They have emotions. Oh, this poor kid. All right, here we go. This is it, right? Yep. Getting close. Oh, no. Oh, poor little guy. All right, and the Reaper should be on his way, right? Let's see if we can spot him. There he is.
Spotted Reaper.
All right, so he's going to check his list on the tablet, make sure he's got the right sim here. I'm pretty sure he does. Gabriel Felipe says this broadcast is going to be the one that goes down where the producers just killed a bunch of kids. All right, so let's have the Reaper take them, and then we'll bring one of the ghosts out here. Wow. Yeah, he's definitely going to miss school.
Okay, he's ready.
All right, there we go. So now we have three different tombstones to choose from. And of course, if you have Death by Drowning in the game, we've got to have some cool ghosts. So why don't we bring one of them out? And I'll just quickly note here, that was another kind of cheat interaction that we used because we're on our developer build. You know, ghosts got introduced in the last update. Normally you'd have to wait a couple days and they'd start showing up and coming out of the tombstone in the middle of the night. But just because we're cheating, we can pull one out here quickly just so you can see what those Death by Drowning ghosts look like. So yeah, let's get the whole family back out here.
See, I revived them.
That's not too sad. You can bring your ghosts back to life too. So it's not the end of the line for our Sims here. But if we zoom in closely on these ghosts, we can actually start to see what's interesting and different about them as drowning ghosts. And that was something Miriko was interested in, and a Mystical Maid was asking about it as well. So yeah, if we get close to them, we can see they actually have little puddles or drops of water coming off of them.
Oh, let me slow down. She's angry.
She is angry. I'd be angry too.
Well, she's talking to the Reaper now.
So you can see the little drops of water coming off of her, and that'll actually create puddles around the home as well, right? Yep. As they kind of move around. So you've got to be careful about that. And then the other kind of interesting thing about Sims who died by drowning is they are not a fan of water, right?
Correct. I'm trying to get her to take a shower. Let me show you.
Take a shower in the broken sink water. Oh, nope, she's already going in there. So Audie Girl had an interesting one. Can you place rooms in the pool? So you can't place a room inside a pool per se, right? But you can make styled rooms.
Mm-hmm.
Am I on the right track there?
Yep.
Okay. Maybe we can just show
people
that.
Show you that. Yeah. All right. So you just click on the room like you do with any other room.
Mm-hmm.
Go to save room. You'll have your pool. Just name it pools. And then you pick what type. So I just use outdoor.
Mm-hmm.
Save.
And so now it'll actually be down there in your styled room.
Yep.
Right?
So if you click on your...
You have to pull it down from the library again. Oh, no. If you go over to your gallery and go to my library, just drag that one in. Place room. Should do it. So now... might be a little funky on our developer.
Oh, board. You know what? It's an outdoor.
Oh, that's why.
It's
silly us.
It doesn't show up.
Okay, so there it is. It's saved, and we can just drop that back down on the water,
yep.
Right? My Sim Addiction was interested if there's any pool-related whims. Anything like, I've got a whim to go swimming.
Yes. There's like whims to place a pool, to place a ladder, place a light.
Mm-hmm. So we do have some in there.
Yep.
And this question always comes up. I really should have tried this out myself. But I Punkit wants to know if the Grim Reaper can swim. And I don't think either of us had actually tried it so far, right?
I don't think he can.
Yeah, I'd go experiment with it today, see if you can get a reaper in the pool. Ooh, I've got it. Maybe it's a clever way to do it. Have a pool, like, within an island, within a pool, and have a sim drown inside that one so the reaper has to, like, route over to it. I don't know. People will come up with all sorts of ways, I'm sure. Go give it a try.
So I just had one of the ghosts that drowned jump into the pool, and they get the...
There we go.
Hydrophobia.
So not a trait, but definitely a moodlet for these poor drowned sims.
I think that happens when you do shower too, but the shower kept getting stolen from me, so I just had a
I'll take a couple more questions that pop in. We're going to wrap up fairly soon here. Maybe just while I'm looking at some of those last questions, take a quick little fly through of the neighborhood, show off some of the other cool things
we
built.
Have one thing we actually didn't cover, we didn't do.
Oh, yeah. Couch. Yeah, go ahead. So, oh, yeah, for sure. We should show that.
So I'll show you guys that real quick. The ghosts.
So this is for adults and children, right?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So there's a coach interaction. So he's going to coach him how to swim.
It's so funny how the ghosts just go through each other. So he's actually helping him learn how to swim. And because there isn't a specific swimming skill, that's, again, building his motor skill.
Yeah.
Audie Loves Dogs wanted to know if you can push people into the pool if they're near the edge.
No, but that would be funny.
That would be funny. We'll have to think about that one.
All right. I'll do a neighborhood fan now. But this is the demo house that we've been looking at.
Oh, I just spotted Lisa Hu in Twitch asking about the Mac version. Maybe you heard our update last month where we said we are working on the Mac version. Don't have any specifically new information to share there yet, but we are working on it. It is coming, so Mac players out there, stay tuned for that. That's a fun one.
The neighbors. And you'll see some of this in the, if you haven't seen it yet, it's in the trailer. A lot of these homes are in the trailer as well.
And that's ours from today, and that one's going to go up on the gallery a little bit later. All right, I think that's about it for questions then. Any last awesome pool thoughts, Stephanie? Put you on the spot.
Go play them and share with me your homes on Twitter. Sim Guru Steph.
Yeah, so not only are you seeing it here in the broadcast right now, this is the updates live. It went out this morning.
Yeah.
It's free for anybody who owns The Sims 4. You just log on to Origin. It's going to automatically update your game, and you can go play with them right now.
Yeah.
Awesome.
One of the favorite things that I have with pools is just kind of watching them socialize together. It's really cool.
Yeah.
Kind of have that feeling.
Yeah. And yeah, if you have any additional questions, Sim Guru Steph on Twitter, Sim Guru Graham on Twitter. We'll be around. We'll be happy to chat with you all if we didn't hit your question in Twitch today. So, yeah, enjoy pools, everybody.
Thanks.
Thank you for
joining us.
Bye.
Nice job.